Greetings. In many videos, I document and provide facts and evidence of what the prophets said. The truth is in black and white for any honest person to see. But Islam has a well-rehearsed and thoroughly programmed response to the truth.
The Torah and the Bible have been corrupted.
This is a feeble lie, promulgated by Mohammedism to cloud the minds of its slaves, captives, and sycophants. But does Islam's claim make any sense? Does it withstand any form of examination? The Torah and Bible have been corrupted. First, understand why Islam must make this claim against the Word of God. The Torah and Bible simply contradict and utterly refute the Quran. So Islam must say something to discredit this threat to the book they worship. The Torah and Bible have been corrupted. But that is such a baseless and unsupported conjecture. But let us examine the claim critically, even though it is total nonsense.
The Torah and Bible have been corrupted.
The first problem is widely known. Muhammad's only credentials come from his claim to be found in the Torah and Bible. The second problem, equally damning, is that the Quran claims the Torah and Bible are the word of Allah. The realized problem is the internal contradiction, wherein the Quran claims the word of Allah cannot be changed. So claiming the Torah and Bible are changed contradicts the claim that the word of Allah cannot be changed. Most followers of Islamic thinking cannot grasp this contradiction. Those who can see the threat have invented other responses. Some will claim the assertion of unchangeability only means the Quran. But that is made-up nonsense that the Quran does not say. So already there are two damning problems that logically destroy Islam's claim. The third problem is the Quran itself, damning the falsehood because Muhammad confirmed the Torah and Bible between his hands of his day. Calling Muhammad a liar and calling the Quran a lie are not winning logical arguments to defend Muhammad and his Quran. But let's bypass those sledgehammers of death for Islam's claim and consider a more gentle and reasoned refutation. Let us imagine their claim is true and examine the logical implications their fable demands.
The Torah and Bible have been corrupted.
When did this invented corruption happen? None in Islam can say or can present any original text. Let's not get derailed by these begging questions.
The Torah and Bible have been corrupted.
What was changed? What books and what verses? None in Islam can say. They do not have any original text. Just believe they are corrupted because they refute the Quran, which actually says they are confirmed. Now, Muhammad tried to play nicey-nice with the Jews and Christians.
I will mouth words of respect for your books if you will bow down to my book. I will claim to respect your prophets if you will worship me as a prophet.
The Torah and Bible have been corrupted.
Just what are the real implications of the claim? If the Torah and Bible have been corrupted, you must hate those who corrupted it. That means you must accept Islam's inbred hatred of the Jewish people. To believe Islam, you must accept the evil Jews have corrupted the word of Allah.
But not wonder what makes the evil Jews stronger than Allah.
So let's imagine the evil Jews corrupted the word of Allah. Do you realize what that means?
The evil Jews changed the message of the prophets.
That means they changed the things, the events, the prophets prophesied. Don't you think for a moment that would farkle up Allah's plans? Just imagine, Allah sent prophets describing how Jesus would really appear as the Muslim Messiah. Allah really said that the Messiah would be born to a couple of homosexual Arab witches in Mecca. And those evil Jews went and changed the prophecy to the Messiah being born of a chaste virgin and in Bethlehem. Do you think that Allah is now suddenly obligated to change his plans? Whatever plans Allah had with the homosexual Arab witches in Mecca, Allah now needed to abandon them. Allah now needed to learn where Bethlehem was on the map. And what about Allah's prophecies that Messiah would be the Caliph and live a long life and have many wives and many children? When those evil Jews went and changed the prophecies to be that Messiah was crucified, pierced hand and foot and in his side, Allah was not slave to the words of the Jews, the evil Jews who changed Allah's original prophecies of Messiah's life. When they wrote, they would cast lots for his garments. Did Allah now suddenly need to allow gambling? When the evil Jews wrote that not one bone of his body would be broken, were the evil Jews really just trying to make Allah look stupid? Messiah will be beaten and crucified, and not one bone shall be broken.
Ha! Said the evil Jews. There's no way Allah can make that happen.
I do not think so. God's message cannot be changed. Satan can try, but he will never succeed. Even if Satan could change the words, the events God said would happen would still happen. And that would create an observable disconnect, of which there are none. Messiah was born in Bethlehem to a virgin, not to a pair of Arab homosexual witches in Mecca. Changing the description of the future events would not, could not, change the events themselves. In fact, it would force disconnects between the events and the prophecies. Every prophecy changed by men would fail. Think of each prophecy by God as the combination lock to his message. God proved his message by the prophecies and their fulfillment. Prophecies changed would not be fulfilled. That would prove them false. When none fail, that also tells you something. The message of the prophets was unchanged. The message of the prophets we have today is the unchangeable, unchanged Word of God. The Torah and the Bible have been corrupted. Lord, please forgive me. I just have to call that lie from hell's religion bullshit. A lie that damns sincere but foolish people to an eternity in hell. The Torah and Bible have been corrupted. Don't believe that lie from Islam or all the other lies from Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.